Yes, you correctly observed that I pay attention to the coins. I have another book concerning the Byzantium coins in the Eastern Carpathia region, and but we could discuss on another occasion about the coinage in this area. But for this period of times, a long period, scholars call this area or this period the period without coins or without coinage. Which is not correctly, because we have not so many coins like we have in Roman time, but in early Middle Ages, especially 8th and 9th century, we have some kind of coins, especially coming from Byzantium, but also we have some Arabic coins coming from the East. And at the end of this period, let's say second half of 9th century, a new, let's say, wave of coinage coming from the West, from Western kingdom and settle in this area. We cannot talk about the so high role of the coins in the local economies. That's why my conclusion was times it's a coins without trade and trade without coins, because we cannot see and we cannot observe the main factor, the coin as a main factor in exchange process. But we have some coins related to, I don't know, maybe occasional exchanges between Byzantium traders and local communities, or some, let's say, military invasions. And by this way, some coins remained in this area. Or we could observe, especially concerning the Arabic coins or Islamic coins, especially from silver, they have been collected as intersect material because of silver, not because of coins. The value, it's not because of coins, but the value of such artifacts because of silver. And we could observe that most of them are collected to be used, I don't know, maybe for production of the jewelry or to be used for different other things to produce the goods for other reason or necessities, not exactly for the coins. And this phenomenon, it's very, let's say, large developed in this during this period of time. We have a lot of discoveries in Europe, in Eastern Europe, and also phenomenon, it's large and developed from the Nordic countries, let's say from Viking area until Byzantium, or from the East, from the Middle East until Central Europe. So the coins are very attractive, are very important, but we have to analyze very carefully the coins in context of the all artifacts which we discover, or which we know from one or another settlement.